This is KGFX 731 on a Friday. It's the morning train as we're broadcasting from Northern Plains Studio. With locations in Gettysburg, Selby, Falkton, Dupree, and Isabel, South Dakota, and Ashley and Strasburg, North Dakota. Good morning on your Friday, the 15th of June. It's time for People in the Neighborhood, and that's proudly brought to you by Lee Real Estate and Vila's Pharmacy.
All day I face the barren waste without the taste of water.
Cool water, water.
Old Ann and I with coats burned dry and soul that's dry for
water.
Water,
cool water, clear water.
That's right, we're going to talk water. We're going to talk Pier water, as a matter of fact, in the studio. Utility Director Brad Palmer, good Friday morning, sir.
Good morning. Thank you.
Welcome back to the show. And we talked off the air a little bit. New since you've been here last is our live feed on YouTube. Just go to Dakota Radio Group's page and look for KGFX as your channels, and you'll be able to find out what's going on in the studio as we sit here and talk about water and the water treatment project in the city of Pier. What's going on?
Well, we started this process over 2 years ago. Actually, it goes back to 2015 when the city commission did a community survey and asked what people were interested in. And at the top of the list was treated water.
Right.
And so they that was important to the citizens, but they also were kind of concerned, what would it cost to have treated water?
So a study began.
Yep. After that, the mayor was very proactive. We went out and we hired a consulting firm, AE2S, and they came in, looked at our system, looked at what demands the system would have, and then what was the best way to provide a treatment plant that could meet the needs of the community. That took over a year to complete that study.
Then the educating of the community begins. You just got to start having some meetings. You got to start getting people together. How did that go?
The commission didn't want to just build the plant. They wanted the citizens to have an opportunity to vote on having a plant, because it was a $37 million investment, mm-hmm. Based on what AE2S told us. And so we set up three public meetings where we would go out and present the information that we found in the study. We would talk about the different treatment processes, the benefits of treated water versus the water that we had been providing. And then we presented that to the community so that the voters would be educated in the benefits, the costs, and that way they could make a vote that reflected what they wanted.
I know that the city of Pier, you guys have been all over this and given people so many opportunities to get educated and to get an opportunity to speak their mind or ask any questions that's going on. And one of the ways that you've done that is the website. It's at cityofpier.org, and there's a water treatment plant project right there. And there's so much information on there that that's got to be very helpful for the city.
Yeah, we wanted to use all the avenues for getting the information out into the community: radio, social media, the web page. And so we just wanted everybody to be in the know as best they could, because, you know, it's very important. This is a big deal for the city. Yeah. And it's going to be something that's going to be a part of our community for the next 50 years.
Yeah, this is going to be exciting, folks. Where are we at now? It was, you know, if folks don't know, the decision, commission put the project to a vote this past June. Project passed 73% of the vote, almost three quarters.
Yeah, that was strong. I mean, we had no idea where this would turn out.
Yeah.
We thought if 60% of the voters said yes, that would be a strong statement. But when it came back 73, well, that just told us that the community is ready for a water treatment plant, and it's something they would very much like to see. So what's happened since the vote, I can tell you, we hit the ground running. We've already met with the consultant, and we're working on an agreement for them to move into the design phase. And we have met with the South Dakota Department of Environment and Natural Resources to talk about funding. And they've met with us, so we've started that ball rolling. We will be working with the DENR on the permitting process, which is a very extensive process to get the permits we need to begin treating water out of the Missouri River. And there's so many players, Game Fishing Park,
yeah.
Corps of Engineers. There's just a lot of things that go into just getting the permission to build a plant like this.
Sure. Folks, if you're wondering what's the big deal about water in Pier, City of Pier Water Department. Pumps and treats, listen to this now, up to 5.5 million gallons of water each day. Million with an M. That's a lot of water.
Yeah, and actually on a hot summer day when it gets temperatures get into triple digits, we can be up as high as 8 to 9 million. So,
wow.
Right now we produce water out of the ground through mm-hmm. wells. It's good water. It meets all the drinking water standards. It's just high in a couple of minerals, iron and manganese, and that results in the staining you see on the sidewalks
taste
and buildings.
As well, yeah.
And taste, yep. So what we'll do is move to a surface water treatment, taking water out of the Missouri River and treating that, and that will be the product that we deliver to the community. So,
okay. So a big change.
Yeah, and a big plant. I mean, to produce that 8 to 9 million gallons, you got to have a plant that can supply that to the community.
It's not just one big fuzzy filter doing this job, is it?
Nope, it's an entire building. But people have had concerns about the fact that the place to build it is going to be down in park area, but mm-hmm. we will work very hard to make a building that fits well into the dynamics of a park and maybe even enhances the park community.
And you can see that, folks, this web page I'm telling you about, cityofpier.org, the water treatment plant project, you can see examples of different facilities that are out there in different towns and some ideas of what route they're going to be going, so you can see what this is going to look like. And it's looking good. I think it's going to look real good.
Yeah, we're hoping that when it's all said and done, not only will we get good water out mm-hmm. of our faucets, but, we'll have a building that is pleasant to look at, integrates well into the park, and that people can be proud of.
This is going to be great. More Kool-Aid for the kids, better than they've ever had it before, right?
That's our goal.
All right. Well, what are we looking at now as far as a project completion date? Is that even in sight yet?
Well, as I said, we've already talked to the engineering firm, and we've began the process. It'll take a year, probably, to get through the permitting process to get the design in place, and then a year and a half to 2 years for construction of the plant. So, we're looking at 2.5 to 3 years before people can turn on that faucet and get the treated water into their homes.
Very exciting. If people have questions, comments, of course, they can always go to that website as well, but can they contact you?
Yeah, there's a ton of information on the website, but they can always call City Hall and ask to speak to somebody, myself or any of the staff there. I think we've all been in this long enough that everybody knows where we're headed, mm-hmm. and we can answer any questions that people might have.
Anything else we need to get out there or need to talk about today?
No, I just think that when we get to the point where we're delivering water that's treated and high quality into the homes, I think almost everybody's going to like
Oh yeah,
the end result.
It's going to be a hill to climb, and it's going to be an expensive hill, but well worth it in the long run, and folks will be happy about that decision, right?
You bet.
All right, there you go, folks. Brad Palmer, great job this morning, sir. Thank you for coming in.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
People in the Neighborhood on your Friday, proudly brought to you by Vila's Pharmacy and Lee Real Estate.